I will be fully honest here. If you don't learn how to think like a programmer, you will never become a programmer. So today, I'm going to break it down to you into easy to follow steps how to learn how to think like a programmer. So if that's something that you'd like, go ahead and smash that like button, subscribe to the channel, and let's dive in. How to think like a programmer. Are rubber ducks better at programming than me? Today we are going to find that out. But the most importantly, we are going to learn how you can think like a programmer so you can write better code. And what is actually programming? Because that is the question here. Programming is actually solving a problem. Like you most probably heard this, like programming is problem solving. But what is actually that? Programming is like 95% of the time thinking about the program, problem solving, and 5% typing out the code. Many of your friends or relatives or family might think that, okay, if you are a programmer, you're just typing out all of that code. And maybe if you are starting out learning to code, you most probably think that you have to learn the code itself, the language. Of course, you do have to do that, but most of your time will not be typing out syntax. It will be about problem solving. Now, how does problem solving work? Well, the first step is understanding the problem. Now, this might sound obvious, of course, you have to understand the problem, but I see that many developers kind of skip over this. They just want to have a solution. They know, okay, let's just type that out. It's a really, really great framework, or I do know how to fix this. No, you have to stop, pause, take a little breath, take a little time with this and understand the problem. You really need to focus on this first, because otherwise, yeah, that's our first step to solving these problems. Make sure that you write down all of the issues, what you want to build, and try to have an overarching view of what you are trying to build. Now, once you have that, okay, you want to build this, and these are the problems that I'm solving with this build, then you want to break it into parts. Now, this is something that most people don't really understand, that this is actually a really important part of programming. You have to break things apart. Like you have a huge problem and then you just take it. Okay, what are the small problems that this large problem can be broken up into? So you see, a big problem equals small problems plus another set of small problems, another set of small problems, and even you can also go further, like those small problems, if you can just break it down into even smaller problems that you have to solve, that's even better. So breaking things down into its parts, it's really essential for you to know as a programmer. Now, if you want to learn how to do this, go ahead and check out rebeloper.com/mentoring, where you can hire me on a 16-minute Zoom call where I can teach you all of this, not just Swift UI or Swift programming. I can also teach you how to think like a programmer and how you can learn better the programming languages or be better at programming in general. It's at rebeloper.com/mentoring. Now, another thing that comes to mind is the rubber duck debugging. And let's get this out of the way straight at the beginning. No, rubber ducks are not better at programming than me, or they are actually not better at programming than you. You most probably knew that. But what is this rubber duck debugging? Well, as you can see, it says talk to a duck. What does that mean? Well, whenever you have this kind of plan and you just chunked it down into these smaller sub problems, then you come up with ideas. Okay, so this is how I'm going to solve this problem, and this is how I'm going to solve that problem. But the key point here is that you want to word it in a way that even a rubber ducky could understand it. So go ahead, take a duck, whatever, just place it on your desk, and then just say it out loud. this is what I'm going to do. I'm going to put up a text field, then I'm going to create a state variable, state private variable for that text field so it can be binded to that text field. I'm going to create a text field style of rounded border. So you want to make it this dialogue, it's not a dialogue, sorry, it's a monologue to that rubber ducky as precise as possible. Also, you might take down your notes, so all of these steps, because if you do this, then you will clearly see what you have to do. Because yeah, you are explaining it to a rubber ducky. Make sure that you go into detail as much as possible. Now, you are done with this part. And now you are starting to type out some code. You are at that 5%. Of course, you do come back and forth between thinking and planning and actually typing. If you were to put a camera on my desk, then you would see that I'm always kind of like 90-95% of the time I'm just thinking, just walking around and trying to solve the problem at hand, and then I'm just typing that. But the actual typing is really, really like small percent of my time. Now, when you do type, please consider this, that computers are dumb. And most people, where they are starting out learning how to code, they don't really realize this. And what I mean here is that they will do exactly what you tell them to do. If you type out, okay, do this, they will do it. You do have to go in and think beforehand of that structure of how you are writing out your code. You do have to feed your computer with actually nearly everything they have to do, because they will do exactly what you want. And if you kind of, okay, I assume that you are going to do this. No, computers, you don't assume that computers will do something. You have to feed them what they have to do. And today is again a day where I pick a winner for the previous YouTube video. And that previous YouTube video was this one. So let's just copy out that link and just paste it in there, right over here. So if you do want to be picked out as the winner, all you have to do is a like, share and comment on this video, and then on the next one I will pick out one winner to be with me on a 60 minute Zoom call. So let's pick a winner right over here. It says Gisela Ramos. Now Gisela, make sure that you contact me at support@rebeloper.com with the email address that you typed in your comment right over here, and yeah, I will meet you on a 60-minute Zoom call. Now, let's go back to our way of how to think like a programmer. And this is something that many, many people fear. They fear to fail. But in programming, especially, you have to fail. You have to practice a lot. You have to fail and learn from your failures. So if I have a problem, okay, I just search for the solution, I just implement it, and then it doesn't go like that. Okay, then I think again, this is what went wrong. I search and try to figure out it from another angle. Okay, then I fail again. And this goes on and on and on till you get experience, till you get to the solution that's actually working. So don't be afraid to fail. You have to fail. You have to practice a lot. And on that practice, you will fail a lot. Don't be afraid to fail. Be afraid of not learning from your failures. But yeah, you have to learn quite a lot here. One thing I usually see with beginner developers is that they want to actually be a smart developer. They kind of come up with these quirky libraries or quirky solutions that are okay and are really, really, like, yeah, quirky is the right word. Quirky for that problem at hand, but always, clean code is better than smart code. Don't be a smarty pants. Just do the clean code with the usual stuff that you have in, let's say, in Swift or Swift UI. Don't be a smart, as you can see. Don't put your sunglasses or glasses below your nose just because you want them to look cool or just solve a problem. Okay? Now, I have to warn you, there are three types of developers, and if you don't know about this, then you might get frustrated or burn out, or yeah, this is kind of my road of staying sane along the way. I've been doing this for more than 11 years now, and this is my go-to when I take a look at other programmers. So, as you can see, there's always somebody better than you, and there's always somebody worse than you. So when you take a look at these programmers, and of course you are kind of in the middle of this, of course, when you take a look at these developers, try to learn as much as possible from the programmer that is better than you, and try to teach as much as possible to the programmer that you think that is worse than you. And then you will not have imposter syndrome, you will not have the syndrome that you are left out of somebody, something, or you are worse than somebody. Make sure that you are 1% better every day. This is your job. Just be 1% better every day. Take that 15 minutes, 20 minutes, 1 hour, 2 hours, or even 3 hours, and code, practice your coding. And then you don't have to worry about all the others. Now, but what do you want to build? And make no mistake, you can build out, you can follow along a lot of tutorials, but there is a kind of a tutorial purgatory where you can just be doing tutorials over and over again, and you don't really know what type of project to build. Now, with this video, you will know the types of projects that you need to build in and the right types of projects. So go ahead and check out what you should build next for your hobby projects, or for you to learn to be a better programmer.